वेलकम टू ई लेक्चर सीरीज फॉर बीटेक फोर्थ सेम सब्जेक्ट डाटा कम्युनिकेशन एंड कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क्स. माई सेल्फ प्रकाश मीना, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग फ्रॉम इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज अजमेर. सो टूडेज टॉपिक इज अवर इंटरनेट प्रोटोकॉल आईपी वर्जन 4. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ आईपी वर्जन 4 इंट्रो. सो वी लुक एट वर्जन 4 ऑफ आईपी एंड ऑफिशियली डिफाइंड इन आरएफसी 791. So you can go and search about RFC 791 for more info. And although it is intended that IP version 4 will ultimately be replaced by IP version 6, and already IP replacement is going on, and so it is currently the standard IP used in TCP/IP networks as well as with IP version 6. And the internet protocol IP is a part of the TCP/IP suite and is the most widely used internet networking protocol. And as with any protocol, standard IP is specified in two parts. First, interface with a higher layer specifying the services that IP provides, and second, the actual protocol format and mechanisms. So here we will study about IP version 4 and IP services and IP header format. So let's start with IP services. So IP services to be provided across adjacent protocol layers between IP and TCP and are expressed in terms of primitives and parameters. And a primitive primitive specifies the function to be performed, and the parameters are used to pass data and control information. The actual form of a primitive is implementation dependent, and there is an example, a procedure call. So IP provides two service primitives at the interface to the next higher layer. The send primitive is used to request transmission of a data unit, and the deliver primitive is used by IP to notify a user of the arrival of a data unit. And the parameters associated with the two primitives are as follows. So start with first source address. So internet network address of sending IP entity used, and second destination address. Contains internet network address of destination IP entity. So you can see here there is a sending IP entity in source address and destination IP entity in destination address. Then third protocol, it provides recipient protocol entity and IP users such as TCP. And then type of service indicators used to specify the treatment of the data unit in its transmission through component networks. The next, identification used in combination with the source and destination addresses and user protocol to identify the data unit uniquely. The this parameter is needed for resembling and error reporting. The next, don't fragment identifier. It indicates whether IP can fragment data to accomplish delivery. And then next, time to live. It measured in seconds for that particular packet. And then data length, it provides length of data being transmitted. Then option data, it provides options requested by the IP user. And then next is data, a user data to be transmitted. So the identification, don't fragment identifier, and time to live parameters are used. Parameters are present in the send primitive but not in the deliver primitive. These three parameters provide instruction to IP that are not of concern to the recipient's IP user. And the option parameter allows for future extensibility and for inclusion of parameters that are usually not invoked. The currently defined options are as follows. So first is security, allows a security label to be attached to a datagram. Then next, source routing, a sequenced list of router addresses that specifies the route to be followed, and routing may be strict, and you can say or loose, strict and loose. And then next is route recording. So a field is allocated to record the sequence of routers visited by the datagram. Then stream identifications, so it provides names, received resources used for stream services, and this service provides special handling for volatile periodic traffic such as voice. And then next is timestamping the source IP entity, and some or all intermediate routers add a timestamp to the data unit as it goes by. Then next is our internet protocol IP version 4. So here you can see a diagram, IP version 4 header, and there are several options mentioned here also. So let's start with here header. The protocol between IP entities is best described with reference to the IP datagram format, and the fields are as follows. So first is 4 bits version. It indicates version number to allow evolution of the protocol. The value is always 4 here. And the next one is internet header length, IHL, 4 bits. Length of a header in 32-bit words, and the minimum value is 5 for a minimum header length of 20 octets. The next is DS, ECN, 8 bits, and it provides prerequisite to the introduction of differentiated services. This field was referred to as the type of service field and specified reliability, precedence, delay and throughput parameters. This interpretation has now been superseded, and the first 6 bits of these fields are now referred to as the DS, differentiated services field, and the remaining 2 bits are reserved for an ECN, explicit congestion notification field, currently in the process of standardization. And the ECN field provides the explicit signaling of congestion in a manner similar to frame relay. Then next, total length 16 bits. It provides total datagram length including header plus data in octets. Then next is identification 16 bits. So it provides a sequence number that together with the source address, destination address and user protocol is intended to identify a datagram uniquely. Thus this number should be unique for the datagram source address, destination address and user protocol for the time during which the datagram will remain in the internet. Then next is flag, 3 bits, and it provides only 2 of the bits are currently defined. So the more bit is used for fragmentation and resembling, and the data don't fragment with prohibits fragmentation when set. This bit may be useful if it is known that the destination does not have the capability to resemble fragments. However, if this bit is set, the datagram will be discarded if it exceeds the maximum size of an in-route network. Therefore, if the bit is set, it may be advisable to use source routing to avoid networks with small maximum packet size. Then next is fragment offset 13 bits. It indicates where in the original datagrams this fragment belongs measured in 64 bits unit. This implies that fragments other than last fragment must contain a field data field that is a multiple of 64 bits in length. Then next is time to live 8 bit. It specifies how long in seconds a datagram is allowed to remain in the internet, and every router that processes a datagram must decrease the TTL by at least 1. So the TTL is similar to a hop count. The next one is protocol 8 bits. It indicates the next higher level protocol that is to receive the data field at the destination, and thus this field identifies the type of the next header in the packet after the IP header, and a complete list you can find out at www.iana.org. Then next is header checksum 16-bit. So an error detecting code applied to the header only, because some header fields may change during transist, and this is re-verified and recomputed at each router. This checksum is formed by taking the ones complement of the 16 bits, ones complement addition of all 16 bit words in the header. And for the purpose of computation, the checksum field is itself initialized to a value of 0. Then next is source address 32 bits. It coded to allow the variable allocation of bits to specify the network and the end system attached to the specified network, as we have discussed. Or then destination address 32 bits, same characteristics at source address. Then next is option variable. It encodes the options requested by the sending user. And next is padding. It's also variable, used to variable size, and used to ensure that the datagram header is a multiple of 32 bits in length. So here you can see options and padding are in variable size. Then another next variable size is data. The data field must be an integer multiple of 8 bits in length, and maximum length of the datagram data field plus header is 65,535 octets. So it should be clear how the IP service is specified in the send and deliver primitives may into the fields of the IP datagram. So you know about the IP header, IP version 4 header, and IP services. So you can refer here the book Computer Network 5th edition, Andrew S. Tannenbaum, for more information. And then we will go further for about the IP version 6 in next video. So the session is ended here, and thank you.